With Pia Alonso-Wurzbach, the reigning Miss Universe 2015, who's going to pass on her crown in just 2 weeks. Pia, hello.
Hi, hi, Diane.
I can't believe it. It's been a little more than a year than we were at the Planet Hollywood where you were crowned Miss Universe. And now in just 2 weeks, you're going to be passing on your crown.
I know.
Tell us what's going through your heart and your head. Paul told me you were a little bit sad when you were packing as you were leaving to come from to Manila.
Well, yeah, I think that's not really a surprise because obviously I love my job very much and I'm going to miss it. And I'll miss everybody at the Miss Universe organization. So of course it was a bit emotional, kind of difficult for me to leave New York, to leave the apartment. But I'll be back. I'll be back in New York, definitely.
Now, you did so many things during your reign. I mean, it might take a whole year to make cuento everything that happened, right? Mm-hmm. But what really stands out in your mind and in your heart?
What really stands out? Well, I can't really think of just one moment out of everything. I feel like every trip that we go to, every time we even visit the Philippines, there's always something new. There's always like a surprise here and there. I guess the most memorable part for me was when I did the homecoming parade.
Homecoming talaga.
Yeah, because that's when I really got to see it for myself. Mm-hmm. How big Miss Universe is in the Philippines, how much we celebrate the competition, and that it's really just beyond the competition and the pageant night, because nakakatuwa lang just to see the smile on people's faces and like people coming up to me and saying that they're inspired by my story or inspired by just the competition itself. And I think it's great. It's great to kind of be able to give back in, at least in that way.
You dreamed about this Miss Universe crown for so long, right?
Yeah.
Was it everything that you expected it to be? Was it more? Were you surprised about anything? Like, ay, ganun pala? Or was it like exactly how you envisioned it to be?
It was more than I expected, definitely, because, you know, I prepared for this for a very long time, and I thought to myself, I know everything there is to know about Miss Universe already,
right,
and I'm prepared for the job. But I guess one of the things I realized being Miss Universe is that, you know, going into the competition, you invest a lot of time in training for the, training in the gym, for example,
right,
or getting fit.
Yeah, you
learning
lost 35
to walk.
Pounds, right?
Yeah, I did. And, you know, getting the right gown, the right walk, the right projection, and being able to answer the questions. But once you win, you don't get to use all of the walking and the, all of that anymore. Yung performance mo on stage, like, that's just for the final night.
Right.
Because what happens during your whole reign is that it's like a whole reign, a whole year of Q&A.
A whole year of Q&A.
Yeah, that's what really happens. And that's what not a lot of people know is that you get a lot of interviews. And they never give me the answers. I have to come up with the answers on my own. When I have to do a speech, I have to write it.
Yeah.
And then when I have an interview, whether it be a bit more serious or more on the lighter side, then I also have to come up with my own answers. So I feel like when you watch the pageant night, the bit that really matters is the Q&A, because you're going to be using that skill during the whole year.
So you mean to say that you were constantly studying, like updating yourself with current events and things that are going on around the world, because that's what this was really... I mean, after you won, people really just wanted to hear what Miss Universe had to say.
Yeah,
right?
and I like that, though, because it keeps you working, you know? You feel like, oh, I answered the final question, I'm done. I never have to answer questions again. But then you do. You have to keep yourself updated with whatever's happening in your country and around the world, and be able to answer questions, and not just with current events, but also within yourself. Like, you learn more. Like, I thought, like, I knew everything there was to know about myself already, but I grew so much as a person during this whole year. Marami talagang matututunan.
You know, you keep telling me that you grew so much. What really is it about yourself that you feel like really changed or developed, or what did you learn about yourself during this year?
Marami, kasi I learned, you know, you start thinking about, because for a very long time, my goal was to compete and to win the crown and be Miss Universe. But then now you won already, now what? So now you start thinking beyond that. You start thinking, what else can I do besides this? All right, I got this already, but I know it doesn't end here. So now I have to think about other goals, other plans, even after Miss Universe. And I think that's where the real lessons come in, because now you have to, you know, face the real world. And then now you have to make decisions now that you're out of the competition. Yeah. So,
Pia, in your whole year as Miss Universe, what do you think was your biggest accomplishment? And what was most significant for you?
The one thing that I'm really proud of as Miss Universe was that I'm able to kind of change the perception of beauty queens, how people perceive us. Like, we're not rehearsed, or we're not robots, we're human. Mm-hmm. And, you know, that I stay true to myself, and I still do that. And that's how I want to be remembered. I don't want to be remembered as, beauty queen, Miss Universe 2015, that's it. Like, I want to be remembered, Pia, that's Pia. So even after Miss Universe, people are going to call me Pia, because that's how they know me, that's how I present myself, I stay true to myself. And actually, mahirap yun. It's easier said than done, because it's so easy that once you wear the sash, you kind of feel like you have to put on this persona.
Yeah.
But then with me, I was able to find that balance. So
you want to be known as a natural Miss Universe.
Yes, like relatable, somebody that people watch and they can connect with, because some people like to put us on this pedestal where parang unreachable and
perfect.
Yeah, perfect. Like, you can do no wrong. But the thing with me is, like, probably people didn't expect me to be wearing jeans during this interview, you know? I'm just like everybody else.
So, Pia, I know you talked a lot about your campaign to help with HIV awareness before the pageant. Were you able to do that during your reign?
Yeah. I always said that I was going to raise awareness on HIV and AIDS, especially here in the Philippines. And the thing is, Diane, it takes more than a year to make a change. Mm. To learn also. Yeah. I feel like I don't know everything about it yet.
Yeah.
I still have much to learn. But with everything I've learned so far, I was able to share it. And it takes more than a year to really make a change. Am I finished with it? I don't think so. I do plan on continuing with my mission with that. And, you know, at least I got the people thinking. That's what's most important to me. It's not, now I got them to think about their status and to think about their stand. And now people know what HIV is. Siguro, there are some people before that really didn't know much about it. Or maybe they thought they knew, but now they know a little bit more. And to me, that's good enough. But let's continue on, diba?
Yeah. Okay, I know you're a planner, right? So now that it's almost 2 weeks till you pass your crown. So after that, Pia, everybody wants to know, ano nang susunod? Ano mga plano mo? Specifically for the next, like, couple months, anong pwede mo bang sabihin, like, couple of projects that are you're gonna be doing?
I'm very grateful na may nakasunod na agad na trabaho. Mm-hmm. May naka-line up na agad. Actually, yung buong February ko, puno na.
Really? Where?
Yeah. Well, for February, I'm gonna be staying here kasi kailangan kong mag-shoot ulit ng mga endorsements.
Oh, so you have a lot of endorsements.
Yeah.
And here in the Philippines.
Here in the Philippines. And of course, I'll still be flying overseas, pero around here in Asia, because also with Asia's Next Top Model, I have to finish that also. And after that, I'm going back to New York. So,
to say hi to Esther?
No, to work, actually. I'm going back to New York to work. And you know, we'll see where it goes from there.
You know,
there.
Paula told me that they were sort of thinking about you being like an ambassador for the Miss Universe. Can you tell us about that?
They did mention that to me before I left New York.
Yes.
And we're still finalizing everything now with the legal team of Miss Universe. But, you know, she's right. We did talk about that. So I guess I'm staying.
Oh. So ready ka na to pass your crown, Pia?
I'm ready to pass on the crown to the new winner. I'm happy, and I feel relieved that I'll still be working closely with the organization even after I pass on the crown. I'm excited because I'm ready to move forward.
Right.
And na-excited na rin ako to see another girl fulfill her dream.
Right. Well, speaking of the other girls, the candidates, I was with them in Vegan yesterday and this morning, and you've seen some of them.
Yeah.
What are your thoughts on this batch of girls? Because I'm sure you, when you got to the Miss Universe pageant the first couple of days, you were looking at everybody,
yeah.
Right?
Ang napansin ko, I mean, I haven't met everybody. Maybe tonight I will. Actually, yes, tonight I will. But with this batch of girls, I noticed right away that they're very, the difference from my year. Mm-hmm. I mean, you know, obviously every year you get a different group of girls and iba-iba yung chemistry nilang lahat. With this batch, very light yung energy.
Very
light. Chill sila. Kasi nung batch ko, medyo competitive kaming lahat eh. Lahat kami gigil. Itong batch na to, nakikita ko nag-enjoy sila.
Parang enjoy lang.
Oo. Pero it doesn't mean to say that they're not taking it seriously. They are. They want to win. But at the same time, I can see that it doesn't feel forced. You know, the friendliness isn't forced.
Yeah.
And the smiles aren't forced either. So I like that.
Yes. Miss Universe has said that you are now the standard for the Miss Universe, that you did so well. So what would you be able to tell the girls at this point of the pageant? 2 weeks to go, there are a lot of activities, they're tired, you know, I mean, what was your mindset at this point of the competition? First
two
few
weeks.
Days. Yeah.
2 weeks before.
Like, so start pa lang yung mga biyahe-biyahe, di ba?
Kasi ang pinagkaiba, nung nasa Planet Hollywood kami, most of our activities were inside the hotel. It was very rare for us to actually leave the hotel. This new batch of girls, they're very lucky because they get to, you know, fly out and they get to visit the country.
Mm-mm.
So hindi sila stuck sa hotel. I think that's very good. They should enjoy it. It's going to be exhausting because compared to Vegas, this is about 2 weeks and a half, where in Vegas it was 3 weeks. Mas sa tingin ko, they're trying to fit everything in that amount of time. So keep your energy up, you know, rest when you can, eat properly. Ito yung problem kasi minsan sobrang diet conscious.
Yeah.
Like the diet pa rin. Pero you have to eat, girls. Like, you'll burn it off. Don't worry about it. And also,
how did you keep your energy, Pia, during the 3 weeks? Plus, you know, during this one year reign? Because, I mean, Paul and everybody has said that your stamina was unbelievable.
Pagka nakikita ko na hindi napapagod the people around me, I think to myself, if they're not tired, then why should I be tired?
Yeah.
So I see them, you know, I see them fighting on. Then I should too. So I get my energy from the people around me. That's it. And as a candidate, just remember why you're in the competition.
Yeah. A lot of the girls, specifically yung mga Asians, were saying, wow, ang tatangkad ng mga girls. So, and you were not the tallest.
Yeah, also. I was definitely
so,
not tall.
Hindi ka na-intimidated, di ba? Yeah. How do you not stay intimidated and just, you know, be confident on who you are.
Yeah, I mean, now if they see me in person, lalo na, well, this batch of girls in particular, a lot of them are quite tall compared to the last Miss Universe competition. Maraming matatangkad this year. But I think when they see me, marirealize nila na it's not a competition where they pick the tallest girl. It's not about that at all. I mean, at this point, hindi na nila tinitingnan yung height. Kasi pumasa ka na dun sa country mo eh. You already made it here. You have just as good of a chance as the other candidates.
Yeah. Well, you stood out though. How did you make yourself stand out? Is that just all the practice or talagang destiny? What do you think?
Kasi nasa energy mo rin yan. Nakikita kasi on stage, mahirap i-fake yung reaction mo, pag tinawag yung pangalan mo, or the way you answer, the way you project yourself. I mean, you can practice, you can train for it, but when you're there, the judges have an eye for that. They can tell. They'd be able to read the girl without with a few moments of looking at her.
Tip mo para sa mga candidates when they face the preliminary judges, kasi 4 minutes yon, di ba? Mm-hmm. 4 minutes of interview.
Yeah.
Di ba?
4 minute.
Parang interaction.
If they do the same setup as last year, then there's two panels, so it's 4 minutes on 4 minutes on each side. So I would say about 8-10 minutes
okay,
of
ano
interview.
Ginawa mo?
sa akin kasi, what happens is, you know, the judges get to ask you questions. They're interested in about you, and it's not really having the perfect answer or being like politically correct. It's not about that. They want to know about you. Mm-hmm. They don't want to know about, oh, Philippines, all right, in your country, we're here, we heard this and that's happening. What can you say about that? Mm-hmm. That's not the time to ask. They're interested in the girl behind the sash.
Yeah.
So they're going to be asking questions about what your life is outside of the competition. Ano bang ginagawa mo sa country mo? Yeah. So, you know, my advice for the girls is don't, kasi the interviews happen kind of simultaneously. Don't listen to the other candidates as they're answering. Don't get distracted.
Oh.
Focus on yourself. Presence of mind.
Yeah.
Listen to the question. Answer. Know when to end your answer. Move on to the next question. I think it's a good Q&A practice, you know? It's good Q&A practice. So,
well, were you trained for the Q&A for so long, diba?
Yeah, and it's my favorite part, diba?
Yeah, that's okay.
But that's my advice. There's really, I can't say na, oh, answer as many questions as you can.
So whatever comes to your mind, ganun lang, yun dapat sabihin.
Yun lang, sabihin mo, and then when you're finished, you hear the next question, ganun. Hindi naman yun yung, the more questions you answer, the higher chance of winning. It's not like that.
Yes. So, you know, the Philippines is so famous na nga around the world because of you. Now, Maxine, of course, Medina, our Binibini Pilipinas Universe, syempre, she really wants to win back-to-back after you. Mm-hmm. You understand the pressure on her, no?
Oh, yeah.
You've talked to her. What have you shared with her para medyo makalma siya?
I've talked to her, yes. I've given her some advice on how to stay calm during this whole competition. She knows. I mean, that's between me and her na lang. But the thing is, I shared my advice with her already, and you know, with all of the girls that I met, with the other girls that I crowned, like Miss Peru, for example, I crowned her, and I try whenever they get the chance to talk to me and they ask me questions, I answer fairly naman, like hindi naman ako biased eh.
Yeah.
Hindi naman porket Filipina ako parang hindi ako magshare ng advice, because this girl also has dreams, you know, and they all have dreams. So hindi naman ako yung namimili ng gusto kong manalo or namimili ng candidate.
Pia, do you think that the Miss Universe should speak English?
For the Q&A, not necessarily so. Although it is a plus that she's able to speak English during her interviews after she wins.
Yeah, because all the interviews are mostly
gonna be in the US.
Right?
Yeah, so it's gonna be very helpful if she can express herself in English. Although for the competition itself, I don't think it would affect her chances if she decided to speak in her native language.
So pwede pala.
Pwede naman. Kaya naman maybe option eh. Like, I don't think they would give you the option of using an interpreter if they thought that it would ruin your chances. Hindi naman ganun yung Miss Universe. You know, whatever you're comfortable with, then you do that. But definitely after the competition, based on my experience, mas madali talaga pagka English. Because what happens is pag ini-interview ka, nanalo ka na.
Yeah.
Ini-interview ka, andyan yung interpreter mo. So nauubos yung oras sa pasahan na ganon.
Yeah.
Mas maganda sana kung mabilis na.
Yeah, I remember your first week as Miss Universe in New York, right? You had like about 200 interviews in every TV station.
Naubusan na nga ako ng mga sasabihin nun eh. Parang, teka, parang, nire-repeat ko na lang yung mga answers ko, ganyan. Pero, yeah, it's going to be very hectic. So, I hope whoever the new Miss Universe is gonna be, I hope she's ready.
Yeah, well, Pia, you, everybody says na super blooming ka, bawat balik mo dito, mas maganda ka pa, and they attribute that to your happy love life now.
Sabi ko na, yan ang tatunungin mo.
I'm sure tinanong ni Tito. So, of course, we saw that you had a very happy new year with my good friend, actually, Marlon Stockinger, because I've been covering him as a race car driver since he was 14 years old.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, by coincidence.
You know him better than me, then maybe I should be asking you the questions. So, Diane, is there anything I should be aware of? I'm just kidding.
So, how committed is he to you?
We are together. And
officially together.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. And he's, I'm glad that I finally met somebody who's very secure with himself and who understands my job and who's not afraid to let me have my moment, such as right now that the competition is happening here. He's very understanding and we really get along. And I'm very happy. And I also love the fact that he's a Filipino and that...
Half European though, like you.
Yeah.
Wait, the dad is Swiss.
Yes. Yeah. And that he's also a Catholic. So I think we have a lot of things in common. And
Best trait of Marlon that really makes you... Kasi nakikita ko sa mga picture niyo, palagi kang super smile. Ano yung pinakagusto mo about him?
He's very funny. Like, he always makes me laugh. Yeah. Mm. And I'm hindi pilit. Yung parang dahil gusto ko siya, natatawa lang ako. Alam mo yung may ganun eh. Couple kayo, pero alam mong baduy siya, pero tatawa ka. Pero hindi sa kanya.
Can you
genuine.
Be yourself when you're around him?
Oh, yeah. He knows a lot of things about me. Probably I shouldn't tell other people, but he's cool with it, so.
Does Esther like him?
Yes. Esther approves. That's the number one thing. And the thing is, Paula likes him. Esther likes him. The Miss Universe organization likes him. So that's a huge relief on my part because I don't have to worry.
Okay, Pia, after you pass on the crown, what are you going to do right after that? Where are you going to go? Where have you planned
Well, my family is actually flying here. They're arriving tonight. My sister, her fiance, and my niece, Lara, my infamous niece on Instagram, she's going to be here. So I'll be spending some time with family. I'm going to work straight away, though, which is great. So it's going to keep me busy. I'll still be continuing with my advocacies with HIV and AIDS. I am actually planning on starting my own foundation. I haven't thought of a name yet. So
what will the foundation be working with? What type of work?
I want to actually partner with UNICEF and Pay It Forward. Pay It Forward is one of our sponsors right here in the Miss Universe competition, and we've started talking already, but we'll be able to focus more on it after the competition because right now everything's been crazy, but I still haven't forgotten about that. So especially now that, unfortunately, someone very close to me has it, and now it's like really starting to hit home. And I'll still continue working on that. And with regards to my career.
Yeah. What about yung pagiging Bond girl mo?
Kaya nga babalik ako ng New York to fulfill my other dreams.
acting ano, aspirations naman sa New York.
Pwede rin, or modeling. We'll see where it goes.
Okay, you
para may surprise element naman dayan.
But you're always gonna be coming back here sa Pilipinas, then going back and forth to New York.
Yes.
Then sabi mo sa akin, forever ka nagda-diet. So anong mga unang kakainan mo after you pass on the crown na bawal during your reign?
Wala namang bawal during the reign. Actually, ang Miss Universe nga ayaw nila nang masyadong pumapayat.
Oh.
Kasi my time this year, I don't know if you noticed, but there was a time where I lost a lot of weight.
Yeah.
I think this was right after the Binibining Pilipinas coronation last year. And that worried them a little bit. They said that hindi magandang tingnan, especially that the kids are probably gonna follow what I'm doing. So it's better to just enjoy everything in moderation.
Pia, happiness level 1 to 10.
Well, can we add a 0 to the 10? 100.
So you've achieved all your dreams. I mean, a year ago it was so different, and now it's like you've accomplished everything you ever wanted. So
there's really not much more I could ask for, because I was so happy enough that I was able to compete at Miss Universe, let alone win Miss Universe, and now the competition is happening here. Sobrang saya ko because I feel like I'm giving back, you know? And also, like, for myself, pagka napas ko na yung crown, I won't have to turn around and look for home, because I am home.
That's right. Well, Pia, what are you going to be wearing on a fashion night? Surprise,
surprise!
I guess. I heard nag-fitting kayo, ha?
Nag-fitting na kami. Kami. Marami.
So
maraming
you're still,
changes.
You're still choosing.
I have a gown in mind already for the final walk. Surprise na lang.
Surprise, okay.
Parang yung competition, surprise lang din.
Okay, so Pia, ang final word mo sa ating mga fans, kababayan, we're so happy that, of course, the pageant is happening here. What can you tell us about the coronation night, if you
of
have
course.
Any surprises?
Guys, you still, you know, there's still a, you can still join the Omaze competition that
right,
we have happening online. Yes, so anybody who wants to watch the Miss Universe competition live, and maybe you want to have dinner with me, maybe you want me to crown you as the next Miss Universe on stage, maybe you want to watch the show live with a friend, all you have to do is go to omaze.com/Pia to enter to win. All you have to do is make a donation as little as $10. And then, nakatulong ka na nga, sumali ka pa sa competition wherein you get to watch the competition live and spend the day with me. Now, if you're already here in the Philippines and you're thinking of, well, you want to watch the competition, there's still tickets. You can go to any SM Ticket outlet or go to smticket.com.
Pia, you make us all proud.
Oh, thank you, Diane.
I'm so proud of
you. We've gone so far. You know, guys, Diane was with me throughout the whole Miss Universe competition in Vegas. Maraming alam na sikreto si Diane tungkol sa mga kaganapang backstage sa drama with everything.
Yeah.
But I'm so glad.
It.
Yes, and now we're here. I'm so glad we've made it, you know, so far. And
yes.
Thank you for everything. I remember Diana visited me in my apartment and we did a, di ba nag-prayer tayo before
yeah,
I left?
We prayed.
I still have the Bible. It's actually in my room now, the one you gave me.
Yes.
Yeah.
I'm sure your heart is full of thanks to God, right?
Oh, yes. Oh, definitely. Yeah, definitely.
Every like, day and every night.
Yeah, like I'm just so
you're not,
thankful
not just,
and grateful.
You're not, you're living your dream.
Yeah, and I'm trying as much as I can to share that dream with other people and give back as much as I can. And not forgetting to say thank you to the people who've helped me make this dream come true.
Right. All right, Pia. Well, we're just excited for the coronation night happening on January 30th
yes.
at the Mall of Asia. Continue to make us proud. I know whatever you do, you will always be our Miss Universe.
Ay,
thank you so much. For your time, Esther,
you.
Emily, and everybody at the Miss Universe organization. Stay tuned to ABS-CBN, ANC, DZMM for more updates on all the activities that are happening leading up to the 65th Miss Universe happening right here in the Philippines. Back to studio.
Well, thanks, Diane. Great interview. It will be the country's third time to host the Miss Universe competition after it was held in 1974 and 1994, the Philippines. This year will be represented by 25-year-old interior designer and model Maxine Medina. Aside from Miss Universe 2015, Pia Wurtzbach, other Miss Universe title holders are Margie Moran, who won in 1973, and Gloria Diaz, who made history in 1969. Coronation night of Miss Universe 2016 happens January 30th. And thanks for joining us this afternoon. I'm Carmina Constantino. Stay with ANC. News now comes your way at 2 p.m.